Hello and welcome to this very special episode of RCT2 Germany Weekly. Why is this episode so special? Well, we come to that point later, but let me first introduce my lovely co-host, version 1, the only real version 1 and 2.
Yep. Yes, I'm here. Everyone was like hoping, please let it be someone else.
Nope.
Everyone is disappointed. It's me, I'm here. And I'm gonna speak about the newest new element spotlight with MCI.
Yeah, we are today. We're going to have a look into Liseberg by Legoo. And yeah, why is this park so special? Firstly, it's one spotlight that itself is an astounding achievement.
It's an astonished achievement.
Secondly, it's a recreation of one of my favorite European parks, although I've never been to Liseberg. And thirdly, it's, well, let's put it this way, Legoom found this new element through one of our head-to-head reviews. So basically, if it wasn't for us, this park wouldn't exist, in a very cheesy kind of way. So basically, this park justifies the whole existence of RCT2 Germany, because the only reason we did RCT2 Germany like 6 years ago is to bring people from the internet to the forums, like new elements like RCT World at that time, or like our own shitty board or whatever. So the fact that we brought Legoom to and new elements and this park is the result of that, yeah, that's kind of cool.
You could say that's the best thing that ever came out of our
Yeah, that's the only good thing to ever come out of RCT Germany.
It's like even the 1% that we could claim on this park.
We can't claim shit on this park.
Yeah, but I'm just saying, like, if we could claim 1% of this park, even then 1% would be better than anything else we have done combined.
Yeah. So, where do we start? Of course, it's a recreation of Liseberg, as I said. And Liseberg is a park in Göteborg in Sweden.
Which is a town.
Which Göteborg is a town, yeah. So this park's basically in the middle of a town, like Phantasialand, but not as fucked up as Phantasialand.
It would be funnier if Liseberg was a town in the park called Göteborg.
that would be special. So we're going to start at the entrance, I'd say.
Yeah, the very. Disclaimer: we have never, neither of us have been to Liseberg, and I haven't. And at least I haven't really looked at photos or something, so no. We can't really say if this is all accurate. The only thing I know of the park is like the POVs and the station of Felix, because
that's about my knowledge of the park too. So
yeah, the station of Felix isn't really that hard to remember when you have seen it once. Okay, so the entrance is right next to a street.
Yeah, right next to the street.
I guess that's accurate.
And the famous Gotthard House in Göteborg.
Yes.
Which I really like them. I really like the fact that he included so much of the town on the map, like all around the.
Well, I mean, it's important. Like, if you do a proper Phantasialand recreation, you have to like build the entire town and then a small part of Phantasialand.
Yeah, exactly.
To reflect what the power status is in this.
Where the true power lays.
Yeah, it's like the whole city and like one part. Yeah. Just like the you know, the splash battle.
Yeah.
The park down there. Okay, but let's talk about Sweden. I've never been there.
No, but I will go there in September. Yeah. Well, I will drive through Sweden in September. I'm going to Norway, so.
But I listen to a lot of Swedish bands, so I feel like an honorary Swede.
What the fuck? Okay, you have the entrance, then right next to the entrance, this concert hall. I'm not sure how this is, how the event center, which is very well done.
Which, I mean, it makes sense to have it as a park, I mean. Like, it's difficult, I'm gonna talk a little bit about the park, because it's difficult to talk about a recreation and say, well, that's a good idea he had there, because, you know, he didn't really have ideas, but he recreated. But I mean, it makes sense when it's really in the city.
Yeah, of course.
And I mean, Göteborg is like a little bit bigger than Brühl. And even a little bit bigger than Rust.
and Hustler, but it's smaller than Hustler.
Everything is smaller than Hustler. Yes. So Hustler is the biggest
city. Biggest city in the world.
There are trumps running. Trumps.
There are trumps.
Small little
Donald Trumps running through
Central Park. I like how the entrance is set up. Where people come from, like they have to go over the bridge and stuff. And they really enter the tram, so.
Yeah, the tram is people.
Yeah, that's
a really nice thing.
And a good job hacking it. I mean, you really can't see that there's, like, he made it. It looks really good with how he acted and how he teamed it, so.
Yeah.
I'm stupid.
That's true.
You mentioned last time that you can make it invisible, like the station.
Yeah, you can.
I forgot. Like, I wonder why nobody does that on coasters. Isn't it possible on coasters?
I don't know, actually. I have no idea. I know that Johnny did it in Walibi with the train and with some flat rides, but he didn't do it with the coaster. So I actually don't know if it's just impossible to do with coasters or if it's not worth, because to be honest, most stations are designed in a way that you can't see.
But I mean, but if I want to do my holiday park recreation,
then you should. Then you should.
2011 or
then
something.
You should, of course, be.
You should
make it invisible
for the Expedition Chiefs station. But we are digressing. So let's enter the park with our pockets full of money to buy all this.
Oh, not again.
I mean, like, this park is crazy. Like, I think I would like just not find anything in this park.
Yeah, you would get lost and die in there.
I would get lost, like, in the start. I would be like, let's go to Helix right away, and I would just get lost. And, I don't know. So
one thing I wanted to say is I'm using OpenRCT to watch this park, because my normal RCT can't open the park on my computer. I don't know why, but it works only in OpenRCT. But in OpenRCT, there are some hacks with the entrance huts that are not working. So you kind of, for example, you can see the exit hut, but I'm sure it is invisible in the normal game.
That's correct. I mean, you can just go. I don't know. Maybe I will test it for you. If you can just change it to the no entrance, open RCT2 only, without.
I'm trying it.
It hasn't given me an error. So, I mean, it makes sense that it didn't use it, because, I mean, I'm really looking forward to when just everybody has open RCT and you don't have to. Make it compatible for the normal RCT.
Yeah, that's true. That's really useful.
Especially with this station, hack, makes it so much easier if you just, you know. But let's walk into the park, into the main square with, you know, a lot of water, and a big stage and some buildings, and a restaurant, everything you want in a main street. Well, main plaza, whatever. And it looks nice.
I really like the atmosphere here.
Yeah, it's a atmosphere as if you were in a theme park.
Yeah, it's incredible.
Which is always good. So, yeah, I'm gonna give this part as much attention as I would if I was in the park and just move on. There's the next stage with a piano and two guys. Apparently singing and playing piano. I'm a little bit disappointed. I thought it was a metal band there, because, you know, Sweden.
Oh, Jesus Christ.
What? It's Sweden. Yeah, let's talk about the old-timer. Farfar Spiller. I'm gonna try to speak or...
To pronounce the names correctly.
Yeah. I think
I'm... Good luck with that.
I think I'm pretty close, actually. I think Germans are closer than English, at least, so... But, of course, it could be that our Swedish members are like, what the hell are you talking about? not supposed to pronounce
You mean,
English.
Or one Swedish viewer would just like, ooh.
Well, I mean, there was another one, so. So, I like it. It's small.
Well,
it's
nice. It's, yeah.
It's a trick to ride. As, again, I mean, I assume the park really has that same tractor or old-timer ride, so.
Yeah, he said something in the Redmi that he, that the Kiddyland is like the old version of the Kiddyland, that the Kiddyland he built is not the Kiddyland that you would find if you travel to Liesberg right now. Which is the version of the Kiddyland that he remembers as a kid. Which I think is good.
That makes sense. Like, but when it comes to recreations, I'm really not someone who says, you know, it has to be one-to-one recreated. I have no problem with someone like taking an older Kiddyland and combining it with the new Helix or something.
Exactly.
So, yeah, nothing. I really like how the. I actually really like how there is a how this rafting looks. Kanin Reisan.
Yeah, that's true. When I looked at the park the first time, well, this rafting or kiddie whatever.
Kiddie rafting.
No, I mean it's not a rafting, but I don't know how the actual right name is called the right time.
I guess. I mean, it isn't it like I would imagine that in real life it's like this waltz thingy.
The what?
I think Mark calls it the waltz. You know this what?
The thing we rode in Bayern Park, for example.
Yes.
Or in Heide Park.
I think yeah. I guess that I will go to the Liseberg website actually.
No, don't do it. But what I wanted to say is that I will. Rip that idea and take it into Spree Park. I need one of those.
You are a crafty man.
I mean, I already ripped off Bubble Works, so why not? Why not another one?
Yeah, I mean, why not? That's really the question. So, and after we have written that, because, you know, here we would go to the
Kiddie
Coaster. Circus Expressen.
Or the Count Horse.
Circus Expressen, which is a Kiddie Coaster. So, with my superb Swedish skills, I can tell you that the translation in English is Circus Express.
Another thing I want to mention is that I don't know why, but the park keeps lagging for me. So, the coasters all look very, very, very...
It's pretty slow. I'm gonna uncap my FPS just so that the coasters are faster. Problem is, I think if you uncap the FPS, it's like too fast.
Yeah, it goes unrealistic. So.
Yeah, I mean, because I like the station actually. Like, it's a nice little station. With
holy shit! If you uncap the FPS, this is like on LSD or something, ecstasy.
Yeah, especially he's
just like, so freaking fast.
If you look at the inversions of Helix.
Yeah. But speaking of Helix.
No, we are not going to Helix now. We are going. I mean the park is pretty much, you know, two parts. It's the valley and the hill. So I would just do the valley first and then move on to the hill. Okay. So
I really like the double hopper attraction he has.
I don't know where it is, but yes, I like it too.
It's in the
area. Yeah, it is.
I mean, basically, I like really all of the kiddie area because it's just. I really
I like the custom rides.
Like the.
Yeah. The Zügelkulturen. Kulturen, yes. Nee, Zügelkulturen.
Or the Flugkarussell.
Yeah, the Flugkarussell. Flug. I don't know. I think the Y is like a Ü in Swedish. I think. But I could be wrong.
Dear Swedes, please correct us if you're wrong.
I like the street, even though you can't see anything of this little main street.
Yeah.
But I mean, you can...
It's really, really crammed and chaotic, but I really like it. Like the look of it.
Yeah, I mean... You know, recreation. I guess this street would be like the usual RCT 5 tiles wide street. And we are not gonna talk about Liesebergbahn. Banan. because it's on the hill. So let's let's continue to the Westward, which is, I think, pretty nice. I think he did a really good job with you know, facades and buildings behind it.
Yep.
In a way that it really looks realistic. And this restaurant looks really, really well done from a realistic standpoint.
It looks really good.
You could say it's a real looker. Okay,
let's take the bridge.
Yeah, let's walk over the bridge to the, I guess it's a hotel.
I have no idea. There is a
Jakob Dahls Fabriken.
There is a fun house in the right wing of the building.
So I guess maybe that's not a hotel, but a something else.
Yeah.
Maybe. I don't know. I haven't been to the park, so.
I guess maybe you are right, but maybe you're not.
I don't like the one building with the house with the shops in there looks like, but on the other hand there are parking lots on the other side, so I guess that's like, I would guess the one closer to the hills is a hotel on the higher state levels, higher floors.
Yeah, maybe.
And the other one, I don't know, maybe half of it. I don't know. It's kind of strange. But it looks good, so I guess that's the most important point.
Yeah, that's true. What I really like about the park, I mean the whole park, is that he uses very many round and diagonal pieces. It all looks very natural.
There was a boat. Way. I just noticed the boat. Okay, let's move on before I...
The little fences on the ceiling of the round buildings are very, very, very nice.
Very guile.
Very guile. Very awesome. Much awesome. Much wow.
Much wow. So built. Much wow. Okay, then there was a real rafting.
Yeah.
The Colorado. Colorado. Weird name for us Germans.
I really like
Colorado.
It.
Colorado. So it's like Colorado,
but different.
I thought it was Colorado, and it was like, I don't know, because Keller is basement in German. The basement, yes. And I liked the station and the buildings, like the way it's set up.
Yeah.
Again, I guess you have to credit the real theme park for it, because it's really cool, but I'm gonna credit him here as well, because he managed it. The only problem is that, well, it could be an RCT problem. That those bright roofs glitch through the black roofs.
Yeah, that's true.
It's a little bit weird.
I do have many glitches on the ride with the 1K ruins as well.
Yeah, again, it could be open RCT or could be something else.
It could be or it couldn't be, I don't know. So then
It could be or it could be. That's
so then we have an afterburner, which looks really nice. I just hope it's better than the one in Thor Park, because the one in Thor Park was shit.
Yeah.
Not the one in the Thor Park recreation, but in the actual Thor Park, the afterburner was bullshit. And I just hope...
And it was bad.
No, it was bullshit. Just was a waste of time.
Speaking of wastes of time, there was a mini golf. Looks like it. Man, I really like this building. It looks really cool.
Yeah.
And of course, there is a coaster. Let's just talk about the coaster that you have done a recreation of first. Kanon. Or recreation. You might not remember it, but I do. There was a pro coaster of you. That's how it used to be called.
Yeah, I remember it, but it wasn't a recreation.
It was heavily.
It was basically the launch, the top hat, and the looping, and then everything else.
Everything in the coaster. Okay, man, Baldur's really insane.
Yeah, but I'm having a look at Kanon first, and
Kanon is Kanon.
The launch could have been 20 kph faster. Because the ride is really, really slow. I mean, I know it lags, doesn't actually lag right now, but 1 kph on a top hat is just way too slow. And the launch doesn't look real at all because the train is basically at top speed in the first quarter of it. I really think the launch should be faster.
Yeah.
And actually I'm going to...
I actually zoomed out, so now I can perfectly watch it without any lagging.
I'm going to make that a bit faster. I don't know if it's working or not.
And I guess the coaster will just explode, but it looks nice. And I guess it looks like in real life.
Yeah, the look of it is nice. Looks realistic, just like the real thing. But the pacing is way off.
Well, then of course there is Balder.
Just give me a second, I changed it.
You need so much time.
Yeah. So it's 93 kph now, and it's way better. There's much more...
There's much more yeah.
That's it.
That's the sentence of the day.
Much more yeah, much more wow.
Yeah, I don't really know why he used the launch speed when, you know...
Yeah.
When he has, like, a launch set up afterwards.
I'm not sure if it's working with the... Well, I am actually sure it is working with the LEM coaster because Johnny did it. Or I did it for Johnny. But I don't know how I did it.
Okay. Let's talk about Balder.
Balder, okay.
Balder is a intermean prefab.
Yeah. It is.
Prefab. Not to confuse with prefab.
And I really think he should have used the... Juvenola hypertrains. Because they just look better as an intermin ride, and they have a better pacing.
Yeah, he actually used the 4 person train, which is not really accurate for a intermin wooden coaster. Yeah, the it's funny how the Juvenola ones look exactly like, or pretty much like the
intermin ones.
Intermin prefab. But the coaster itself looks nice.
Yeah. As I said, it could be faster in places. But overall the pacing is... Well, better than on Canon.
Right.
I mean, I have no idea how the real Balder looks like, but... It looks a bit off here, I think. Like, it doesn't really belong in the park. In a weird kind of way.
I mean, I guess that's the same with the real Balder.
I don't know.
I mean, a huge wooden coaster always looks like kind of better than everything else.
Yeah, that's a crazy thing, I think. This one doesn't look better than everything else.
I think it looks great.
Okay, moving on.
Moving on to another... To last...
Did you see the...
I've seen everything.
The car, the truck with the trash cans.
Yes.
Behind Canon.
Yes,
holy,
I have seen
fucking
that.
Shit.
Well...
That's amazing.
It's good.
It's amazing. So shut up.
The thing is, there have been trucks in the past.
Yeah,
and making it... I mean, it's a good idea to do it like that, but...
I think it's amazing, so fuck you. Okay.
Fuck me, right? let's talk about the next part of the valley, or the last part of the valley.
How is the flat ride called?
Which flat ride?
The one next to the Canon top hat.
To the Canon top hat? You mean this, the... I don't know. I actually don't know what this is supposed to be. Like, is it supposed to be something like Samurai in Thor? Or is it... Or was it called Samurai?
I don't know. I know there's a version on the... A traveling version in Germany called Freak Out or something like that. But I don't know what the ride type is called. But it looks good. Yeah. I think it looks good, it looks accurate.
He was really smart in not having to actually have a round counterweight.
Yeah.
Because it's on the bottom. So yeah, Spielhuset. So that's a game thing.
Card, yeah.
With, yeah, I don't know. I like this area. It's I think the calmer area of the park. With a dark white. The saga slotted.
Which looks really nice. I mean, the front of the building is awesome.
Yeah.
Simple as that. And I really like that he had made this hole in the roof so that you can have a look inside.
Yeah.
Because it looks really good.
And the area has a disco coaster, so that's the worst area.
What I'm not exactly sure is why there are facades on the backside. Are there people living there, or why?
Well, maybe you can like on the right. Maybe you can look out of these windows.
Well, that could be true.
In real life.
I don't think so, but it could be true.
Yeah.
And then you have some other small flat rides.
For example, yes. Drakbartarna. Drakbartarna.
And
Bartarna. It's really.
It's the other thing. It's a flying carpet, right?
Yes.
Some weird sort of flying carpet.
This weird different way, like not the.
Not a real flying carpet, but other flying carpet.
Yeah, I mean, but I don't know where this. I think I've seen it right before somewhere.
Yeah, then you have, of course, the Strafen, or whatever it is called, the little football field.
Yeah.
Football, not soccer.
Well, not soccer. Soccer is wrong. But let's talk about the Flum Ride, which is called Flum Ride. With a diagonal lift, which I actually find pretty cool.
Yeah. I don't know. I mean, there are so many straights and areas where nothing happens on this ride.
I think this ride is the best ride in the park. I don't know. Like, the thing is, I would just enjoy these flat parts. It's basically like a scenic railway through the hill. Sides of the park.
Very weird one, yeah. It reminds me a bit of the one in Fort Fun, because that one has long stretches where nothing happens too, but not that long.
Well, I mean, Fort Fun is that big, so.
Yeah. I mean, I really like the look of it, but I'm not sure if it's what I should think of it. I don't know.
I really like that there is a boat. Boat.
Yeah, the boat ride inside the Lock Flum is awesome. And the station of the Lock Flum too. I really like that.
Yeah, it's really bad. Like everything in this park. Okay, there is another plane ride. Fisketuren. So he has it twice now.
Yeah, he also had three freefall towers, so.
Well, I mean, I think the real park has three freefall towers.
It had three. The one we're looking at right here, Obscurelet, is now the one with the Skyfly on top of it.
Obscuted. Try to pronounce the second one, I dare you. Holzkraken. Holzkraken.
I'm not trying to do that.
Yeah, so. I mean the
Has
Ferris wheels. Two Ferris wheels, that's interesting. For the park.
Yeah, a small one and a big one.
Yeah.
One for you and one for.
I would ride.
Without height.
I would ride the big one, actually. I would have ridden the Ferris wheel in Fort Fun, if you remember.
Oh, that's true.
But you didn't want to.
It was cold and windy. So
it was. So let's go further into the hillsides and talk about Liesebergbahn, I guess.
Or Wirbelbahn.
What's Wirbelwind?
It's next to the first.
Wirbelwind. Very interesting. Yeah, it's there and it's nice. I actually like the setting, how it's on one level with the pass on, or with the off on one side and
yep.
lower on the other.
Now,
Liesberg Bahnen.
I mean, Liesberg Bahnen is probably one of the most famous rides in all of Scandinavia.
Well, I mean,
maybe even one of the most famous rides in all of Europe.
This is Schwarzkopf.
Yep.
I mean, it deserves to be so famous, doesn't it?
I can't vote for accuracy because I haven't watched the POV in for ages, but.
But it looks great, and it has great interaction yeah. with everything. And it looks like white. It looks white. I think support work is a little bit dodgy.
Yep.
Sometimes. Except for, especially the very first and on the drop, which goes inwards. So, the same direction as the banking of the.
Yeah. True. This one. It was all in but all, I really like. I mean, the interaction between Helix, the swinging, the screaming swing, and Liesberg Bahn. That's just yeah. off the charts. Don't know about the long straight stretch though. How accurate this is.
I could see it being pretty accurate. I mean, it's old Schwarzkopf.
Yeah, that's true.
I really love this double helix around the helix yeah. top hat. or huge corkscrew, however you want to call it.
Yeah, you do have a roller coaster with a double helix, and you name your new double launch coaster Helix. That's
yeah,
that's cheap.
I mean, and the S&S wing, of course. Like, I would actually enjoy this S&S wing.
That one is yeah. I mean, that's one of the big reasons why I want to go to Liesberg that bad. Because it's really, I mean, the setting. You can't find a better setting for a giant swing than this.
Well, except like if you build a giant swing next to the weird coaster in China, which is on the top of the mountain.
Yeah, okay, that one.
That would be. I actually forgot which coaster it is, but I will never forget how it looks.
Or a giant swing over the Grand Canyon. That would be cool too, but.
I mean, there should be a like I don't know. I mean, you could like in the Grand Canyon, you could build a huge disco coaster.
No.
So let's talk about Helix, because I mean, that's like the marquee coaster of this park right now.
Yeah, that's one hell of a coaster.
Which is insane when you have a intermediate prefab Woody. And the Mac comes and builds this. Like, this would be the first reason for me. Like, I used to forget that Baldur is even in this park because I just thought of Helix.
I mean, I, as I said, I've never been to Liesberg, but Helix is. I mean, I've heard from many of people who actually went there that Helix is one, if not the best steel coaster in Europe.
Well, it's not less. It's no less than you expect from Mack. No,
yeah.
Mack. They really stepped up their game.
But again, in this recreation, I think the pacing is a bit off. Could be faster in a lot of places.
Again, we don't really know how fast it actually is.
Yeah, but it looks in the game, it just looks weird at some points.
But again, I mean, if you have to make it realistically, you might end up with having that problem.
Yeah.
Yeah. The first corkscrew is really slow, but you know, when it comes to realism, you kind of have to build it like that.
And I think the second part of the Norwegian loop could be a bit faster too.
Well, but to be fair, Norwegian loops are really hard to do in RCT because you have like this fixed size for inversions. I mean, the second corkscrew is alright. I mean, I'm just looking at the speedometer.
Basically. Yeah, as do I, because the park is lagging in that area so much that I
mean, I could zoom out, That's always a good trick, by the way. Like, if you can't really watch something smoothly, you can just zoom out of the park and use the right camera, and then the speed will be fine.
The top end is a bit slow too.
Yeah, but the COG afterwards is really, really fast.
Yeah, the last COG, there should have been an...
The top end is actually pretty perfect. Have you considered zooming out?
I just did.
Yeah, like... Yeah, the last COG is again pretty
fast. Yeah, maybe put a trim brake in there. It could save lives. But then again, the interaction between Helix, the pads, Liesbergbahn, and everything in that area is just so incredible.
Incredible.
Incredibile.
And the station is pretty much like it is in real life, I think.
Yeah.
I don't know why they decided to go with this station, but it's kind of cool, I think. I like how the queue.
But you're right, if zoomed out, Novich Loop actually. The pacing in the Novich Loop is actually pretty perfect.
Yeah, so let's talk about the huge Ferris wheel. It's a huge Ferris wheel.
That's the best Ferris wheel ever done in RCT2.
Well, except that it doesn't move.
Yeah, except that, but it's the best looking Ferris wheel ever done.
I agree with that. I like that there are actually tables at the bottom of it. Right there. At the entrance. Pretty cool. Yeah, and then there was this weird elevator thingy. The Universum. Universeum lift.
Yeah, I mean, since I don't have to the park, I don't know what it's supposed to be.
I guess.
But it's cool.
I guess there was some kind of attraction in that building, and you can leave the attraction with this lift thingy.
Maybe.
That's like, that would be my guess. Or maybe it's like another entrance to the park.
I don't know. But I really like the interaction between the outside and on the inside of the park.
I think I really like these narrow paths. I think they look pretty amazing.
Yeah. Well, and of course, on top of the mountain, you also have Atmosphere, the giant intermittent shield drop tower.
Which I will never ride.
Which is a shame, because the view must be one fucking
view.
Hell of a view.
I can ride the Ferris wheel. Similar view. So I guess that's our review of Liesberg.
We haven't done the outside yet.
Well, there was an outside with buildings, and they look nice.
Yeah, that's about it, actually.
Yeah.
I really like the second entrance to the park, in the back, near the Disco Coaster.
I hate Disco Coasters, what? Yeah, that's cool. Which, actually, with like the long way from the street to the entrance, that looks kind of more like a main entrance.
Yeah.
Or like where the main entrance should be. But, no. I mean, I don't know. Like, it would be interesting. I have no idea where you park in this park.
Well, there is a parking building next to the Lock Farm.
Really?
Yeah. On the outside of the park, there's a Lock Farm, there's a parking building.
Actually, but again, like, I mean, there have to be a lot of people in the park on a daily basis, so. But I guess we will find out once we...
We will find out somewhere in the next...
We will find out in 2023.
Or 4.
Or 4.
Not sure about that yet.
Well, I mean, we have to go to England like 4 times before we go to Liesberg.
Yeah, so that's basically it. Thanks for watching, guys. I hope you enjoyed our review of Liesberg.
I hope you don't enjoy it. I hope you were miserable.
So, as always, go to New Elements, download the park, have a look at it yourself, at least have a look at the giant screenshot, and
yeah, because the giant screenshot is way more representable than what we showed.
Full scale screenshot. Yeah, I mean the park is lagging on my PC a bit, so they've got a lagging version, and maybe the screenshot is better in some ways than a lagging version of the game. So, thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed it. You can always subscribe to our channel. We would really enjoy that. You can give us a thumbs up or write a comment about how bad we are and how crappy our English is. You can stalk me on social media. The links are in the video description. And go fuck yourself.
Yes. I agree with that.